I built 3 trading bots to trade stock with $10,000 of my own money. One safe, one risky, and one just absolutely insane. In today's video, I'm gonna show you the process of how I built these bots, all the technology I used, and the results of giving it $10,000. If you're new here, my name is Lewis, and I'm on a mission to inspire developers and tech enthusiasts. Let's go. Okay, so I would never consider myself a finance guy, but I mean, come on, how hard can it be? Buy high, sell low. But surprise, surprise, it's a lot more complicated than that. So I read up on trading strategies. In a short period of time, how can I possibly make more money than I put in? And from my initial research, no one really knows. So you just kind of make it up on the spot until you get so rich, you can wear a suit to work. But here's how I'm going to make my fortune. I'm going to create 3 trading bots that all have different strategies, going from fairly safe all the way to basically burning my money away. The first one is a mix of momentum trading and value trading. It makes decisions on a preset amount of safe stocks and buys or sells depending on how the stock is moving on average. The second bot scans for news articles on a company. If the news is good, we buy. Or if it's bad and we own that stock, we immediately sell. The third bot, I can't even believe I'm doing this. Selects a random stock out of every stock listed, grabs the latest news article about the stock that was picked, and uses AI to determine what Taylor Swift lyric is the most related. If the lyric is happy, we put half the money in. When we hold that stock, we continue grabbing news articles about the stock, and if the lyrics match a negative sentiment, we sell everything. Swift Trade 1.0. This is what I do for a living. You're probably wondering, who would be so stupid to do such a thing? Well, the sponsor of today's video, DataStax, is thinking the same thing.
I'm using DataStax AstroDB to power this application, and when it comes to speed, it's 100% needed when working with databases with vector values. Built on top of Cassandra, AstroDB helps you scale your application without the worries of scaling slowing you down with global scale with serverless architecture, enterprise-level security, and no vendor lock-in. You can literally create a database in just a couple clicks, and it has a bunch of SDKs supported for Python, Node, Go, or even just a CLI. So if you're familiar with Cassandra, then no explanation needed. But if you're like me and don't understand Cassandra, it's still so simple to connect your application and get something up and running in minutes. I created a Chrome extension that lets you talk to YouTube videos easily, with DataStax primarily powering the entire thing. And it was so easy to just build an application quickly that required complex components like a vector database. It's also easy to include in your existing projects. Create a Cassandra vector search for a small business in your area and have a forward-facing chat. It's actually shockingly simple. Leaders in every industry are using DataStax with AstroDB to power their AI applications. And you can too with their extremely generous free tier. Thanks DataStax for enabling my reckless behavior by being the sponsor of today's video. If you're building an AI app or want to build an AI app, please click the link in the description below to learn more about how you can use DataStax in your next project.
So here's how the first trading bot works in detail. Every minute, the bot looks at a predefined set of safe stocks, then looks at the current price, the average price within the last 15 minutes, and the PE ratio, which is the company's earnings to stock price ratio. If a stock is above the average price and the PE ratio is lower than the average, we buy. We then check to see if the moving average is on the way down. If it is, we sell, and then rinse and repeat. I'm of course using Python for all 3 of these bots, and unfortunately I'm using interactive brokers, which is the only option I have as a Canadian, like, really. Also, the interactive brokers API is really bad, but thanks to the magic of open source, someone made a package that makes it a little bit more bearable. What's funny is that the least exciting bot to make is actually the hardest to make. There's a lot of technical, mathematical, finance jargon that I just don't really care about, so I have to look it up, how to implement it, you know. So when you're building one of these bots, the first thing that you do is you backtest. Backtesting is where you take your strategy and see how it performs on historical data. In Python, there's a framework I'm using called Backtrader that lets me implement my strategy and then use it against historical data. And since this is only going to be less than a week, I'm going to only get the last couple of months of data from a set of stocks. I spent so long on this, it's seriously ridiculous, so let's test it. Okay, looks like we need some improvements. Sometimes it's just the numbers that need altered, so a lot of these backtesting libraries let you optimize these numbers by running them all in different combinations and then picking out the best. So let's optimize. 25 different periods, 30 different overbought thresholds, and 30 different oversold thresholds. That means that we're testing over 22,500 different combinations. Let's get started. So for reference, I have 24 different cores on my computer and use them all in parallel. To get this running as fast as possible, it was seriously so loud. And it took over 25 minutes to run with all of these, so insane. And the worst part is that the best return I got was like $23. But that's $23 doing nothing, so I'll do it with these parameters right here. Usually with safer stocks, you plan on selling in like a year or 10 years, but instead I'm doing it in a week, so honestly, $23 honestly might be a win. Let's just convert it into the interactive broker's code and then run it. The second bot scans for news articles on companies. If the news is good, we look up the company that it may be related to, and then we buy. If it's bad and we own that stock, we immediately sell. And this is how we can test how does the news affect the stock market. Something I wasn't expecting was how closed all information is basically everywhere. After the whole Twitter and Reddit API situation, everywhere is doing it now. So it looks like I'm forking up some more cash. First, I downloaded the list of stocks on NASDAQ and New York Stock Exchange. I used OpenAI again to generate a description for each stock, then embed this description so I can vector search it later. Upload to Astra and we're good to go. Easy. All right, let's test it out. Who is Tim Cook? Awesome, so it seems to be working. Coding with Lewis builds awesome trading bots with AI. Okay, cool. Then I plugged in a news API so I can scan for news and identify what stock is likely going to be talked about or affected. Now, the back trading strategy. This one's going to be a little bit more tough considering there's a whole bunch of data outside of just the stock itself. Also, I don't want to use any more API credits. It was already expensive as is and I'm pretty much running out. So I'll write a script to give me the date, headline, sentiment, and stock ticker it's affiliated with. I just got the NVIDIA 4090 and it's really coming in clutch right now with the machine learning aspect of it. And just because I'm curious, let's peek into the final results here. 655 positive articles, 300 neutrals, and 515 negatives. Wow, bummer. All right, this testing shouldn't be too hard. So it was pretty hard. So I have this setup here where I can just put in a stock ticker and it'll use a sentiment analysis based off of what I've done. I'll just do S-Bucks, like Starbucks. And it's actually funny because Starbucks did really well lately, so it was climbed up after a massive thing, which insane, $102. So imagine if 5 days later, I sold it. Let's try Tesla. That'd be a crazy one here. Okay, even there, you make money, dude. Wow, that's actually a crazy, crazy thing. I mean, to be fair, Elon is always getting himself into some crap. Absolutely insane. Okay, let's convert this into interactive broker code and we're off to the races. Here's what we have to do. We select a random stock out of every stock listed. Using the same news API like last time, we grab the 5 most recent articles. We embed the articles and have DataStax match it with the Taylor Swift lyric that relates to it the most. We then determine if this lyric is positive or negative. If it's positive, we buy as much stock as we can. Otherwise, it's time to sell. And I can't even believe that we're doing this, but let's build. First, let's lock down the Taylor Swift lyrics. This one was surprisingly hard to find, but Alice Zhao, or A Dash of Data, provided it all on GitHub and it only has 17 stars. An absolute legend. She literally has no idea how much she's just helping me right now. Now, separate all of the lines of each lyric. For further reference for myself, I'll add what album and song they are from. Now, to save ourselves some time, we can just do the sentiment analysis on every single lyric now, so we can save it into AstroDB. Embed the lyrics and save to a new column, and push up in batches to AstroDB. And after our first test, Awesome. Grab our existing list of stocks. Set up a function to pick one at random so I can grab news data from. And good news, pun intended, is that we already have the news API set up, so we can just reuse a lot of the functions there. Now, let's get some backtests started. How I backtested this was similar to the news sentiment, but it's a bit harder considering it's all random. Sometimes it did really well, sometimes it didn't. And there's 1,000 of stocks available to choose from, so I'm thinking I'm satisfied with my testing. Let's just convert to interactive broker's code and call it a day. So, it's the next day. I have all three bots here, all ready to go. Can I press the button? Here we go. So I was only able to run them for about 3 or 4 days because I had so many issues when I actually deployed it, but more on that later. For now, let's get into the results. So for bot one, only 2 stocks were purchased. Duke Energy was bought the last day of trading, 16 shares at $90.09 with a total of $1,441.44. We then sold like 2 hours later for $89.66 at a loss. So with this stock, we ended up losing $6.88. With Mara, we ended up buying 24 shares at $9.38, totaling to $225.24. We then sold at $10.22, meaning we made a profit of $20.16. Combined both together, and we actually made $13.28.
I mean, I wasn't really going to be surprised that bot number one wasn't going to cause significant loss or gain, but it was fun to do either way.
We bought over 9 stocks. GameStop, we bought 22 shares at $12.76 and then sold at $13.23, meaning we made a profit of $10.15. The Grindr app, we bought 46 shares at $6.14 and then sold at $6.76, giving us a profit of $28.29. Take-Two Interactive, we bought only 1 share at $153.94 and then sold for $154. This was a last-minute trade, so we only made a 6-cent profit. The Insulet Corp, we bought 1 share at $170.05 and sold for $174.26, giving us a profit of $4.22. Hudson Pacific Properties, we bought 50 shares for $5.63 and sold $5.73, giving us a $4.80 profit. AT&T, we bought 18 shares at $15.56 and sold for $15.78, giving us a $3.91 profit. Astra Space, we bought 195 stocks at $1.4488 and then selling at $1.442. This means we got a loss at $1.33. Hudson Global, we bought 18 shares at $15.40 and then sold at $15.47, giving us a $1.26 profit. Molson Coors Beer, we bought 4 stocks at $59.65 and then sold for $59.661, giving us a 4-cent profit.
And the part that you're probably waiting for, the Taylor Swift bot. Here are the results of that.
So we actually only ever bought 2 stocks during our Taylor Swift bot run. I'm thinking maybe this was because of the limited data from when the stocks were initially bought. But the first one was Nuveen Global. Then this article called JGH stayed in the game with Nuveen Global High Income Fund. Somehow related to Stay Beautiful from the song Stay Beautiful from the original Taylor Swift album came up. Not sure why, but it went with it. So we ended up buying 101 shares at $11.22 and then sold at $11.20, which means that we lost $2.02. Then it randomly chose GATX Corporation that leases rail cars to companies. So again, from the album Taylor Swift, it picked out the lyrics "When You Think Tim McGraw" from the song Tim McGraw, and then bought 10 shares at $108.63 and then eventually sold at $110.87, giving us a profit of $22.45.
That's right, we made money off this. real money.
So after all is said and done, all three of our bots brought in a combined $109.35. This is from around 3 to 4 days of active trading and between 13 different stocks, but not all happy. The $109.35 accounts for commissions and fees included, but I also had to buy a lot of subscriptions to access real-time market data. So Interactive Brokers automatically took $117.70 off. So if you actually want to include that in your portfolio, we actually lost $8.35, but I'm going to say that we actually made $109.
The fact that I can gamble $10,000 of my own money is a privilege that I can only get because you keep tuning in to my YouTube shorts, my long form videos, and all my other socials. Coding with Lewis is my full-time job, as well as Will's full-time job, who helps edit these videos. And to me, that's just beyond insane. So thank you so much for supporting me on my journey. We're planning a special event in our Discord channel, so make sure you check it out in the description below to find out more. If you like videos like this, where I actually build things, then check out my Reddit bot, which builds those Reddit TikTok videos that you always see, as well as my news API bot that reports the news to you.